Ramya ma'am is there. Ramya ma'am, you have joined?
Yes, sir. I have joined.
Yeah. So we have another lecture on environment. It is from Dr. Ramya Mohan ma'am. She completed MSc in biotechnology from Periyar University, Salem, India. She completed MPhil from Kripagam University, Coimbatore, India. PhD from Presidency College, Chennai University, Chennai. Worked as a project assistant in Anna University. She has a specialization in environmental biotechnology, antibacterial nanotechnology, enzyme technology, bioinformatics, drug designing using HyperChem and Accelerate Discovery Studio. She had attended and presented paper in 13 national and international conferences. Completed two projects. Now today's topic that she will deliver a lecture on global health concern of cyanobacterial toxins and detection methods. So we welcome you, ma'am, on behalf of our JIT College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Malegaon District, Nasik, Maharashtra. So can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you for the warm welcome and the opportunity that you have given me a short duration of time. Can I proceed, sir?
Yes, sir. Screen is shared. It is visible.
Okay. Thank you so much. Today I'm going to talk about the global health concern of cyanotoxins from lake water and also its various detection method. And it is becoming the one of the important topic nowadays because of after the COVID especially. And because of the pollution that you all know, the major environmental pollution causes the bloom of algal bloom that we all know. And not only that, macroalgae and some of the microalgae like the cyanobacterial blooms also there. And that also produced secondary metabolites. Those are the toxic to the aquatic animals, fishes, cattle, and even to humans. So we are just focusing. Hello? Yeah, we are just focusing on the toxin part, not the plus taken, because with the influence of the toxicity, with the environmental pollution, some of the negative impacts are arising and the positive sides are decreasing. Hence, there is a chance of many problems arising. And these are the most frequently toxin producing cyanobacteria are microcystis, Anabina, nodularia, Plantothics, Aphanizomenon, Cylindroscomopsis, and Lingvia, etc. are involved in toxicity. These are producing the hepatotoxin, neurotoxin, cytotoxin, and dermatotoxins, etc. The hepatotoxins mainly caused by the microcystis and nodularin toxins. Neurotoxins is also caused by anatoxin and saxitoxin. The PSP toxin is produced by Aphanizomenon. Dermatotoxin is lipid phosphate synthase. Toxins are produced. So here we all know as urbanization, due to urbanization, agricultural fertilization, and this industrialization on fossil fuels emissions are major reasons for the deposition of organic and inorganic matters to the ground level. Thereby, the increased biological oxygen demand is causing to the living things. So hence the algal bloom is causing on the surface, and there will be no penetration lately, the lights or the oxygen demand is there. And hence the dead, it becomes the fishes are dying every day. So this is because of the eutrophication and the global climate change. These are cyanobacterial blooms and stems produce secondary metabolites that are toxic to aquatic animals, as I told you before. And this is because of the bloom, the direct from the lake water or the drinking surface water, the kids and many human are drinking directly. And due to the swimming and the intake of the water through swimming also get affected. And the fishes that are consuming by the human also leads to some adverse effects. The life cycle of the cyanobacteria. seasons, the what will happen with the availability of the lights during the spring seasons, the vegetative cells gradually growing to the growing and becomes the growing filaments. And after the end of the summer, there will be a limitation of lights, and hence the nitrogen fixation will be also limited. And there will be a cell called heterocyst that can fix and access the nitrogen fixation. And here the achinides spores are formed. And lately, after the autumn seasons, that gets settled down. And lately, with the availability of vacuoles, again the vegetative cells are being produced. And this is a life cycle of the cyanobacteria. When talk about the blue-green algae secondary metabolites, the cyanobacteria, as I told you before, there are two things are there. One is exhibit of toxins, another one is useful for anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory, etc. We are not talking about that. We are talking about the negative impacts. So on what the impact that produce on the aquatic ecosystems are like many fishes that are consumed by human, those are getting affected. Examples of Daphnia pulicaria, those survivability and its offsprings are immensely reduced. And Daphnia magna, this is the Daphnia magna, the long-term exposure of the toxicity of cyanobacteria inhibits the enzyme reaction inside the fish, that is inhibit the phosphatase enzyme activity. Daphnia galita, the neuromuscular communications affects the heart and also the thoracic. So the swimming, what will happen? The fishes will, their swimming ability as drastically reduced because of the neural affection. And also their liver is affected. After once, it does not show, sometimes it won't die, but the neural and liver get mostly affected when the human consumes those fishes. And they also indirectly get affected, and which does not even know because of the human's biological system. We does not even think about that this is because of the cyanobacterial bloom and toxicity. Since it's a large human genome, so these are all the main causes of that. And also, it affects aquatic species like Dracaena polymorpha mussels and also Ceratophyllum demersum. This is used as a poultry feed, but this is being injected by the microcystis, the LR and RR. These are all the amino acids. So these amino acids of the toxin will get consumed by those fishes, mussels, and also takes up by the Ceratophyllum demersum. And when the fishes consumes this, they eventually get affected. Toxicity of the microcystins for some species of fish and birds, like piscivorous birds, is at risk. Once the piscivorous birds is at risk, without unknowingly the birds, planktivorous fish get affected by the cyanobacterial bloom. And by consuming the piscivorous birds, after consuming the planktivorous fish, that also get affected. So whole environmental life cycle is getting affected, and it's becoming a big boom. 3 months old Cypress carpio affected by the anatoxin. Anatoxin is nothing but the neuron toxin produced by the cyanobacteria, which inhibits the movement of the fish, and also it causes the abnormality in swimming. Yes, this is a neurotoxin of aquatic animals. The saxitoxin is also another toxin which is present in the amino acids in the cyanobacteria with a 500 microgram per liter consumption by Daniel Riro, where the embryos generated malformation happens. Cylindrospermopsis rhacisbursi is another cyanobacteria which has a saxitoxin as secondary metabolites. It also alters the swimming behavior of the fish. And let's talk about the impact on human health. Is in Brazil, Anabina and the microcystis of species affects the gastroenteritis, where the 88 people have died in the period of 42 days. Like the town of Carauro, Brazil, the cyanotoxins affect the 76 patients who died with the contamination in the lake. and also in England, the left basal pneumonia is caused by the Microcystis aeruginosa species, where that microcystin is a toxin present in it. And this is the saxitoxin, neural toxin, which is highly toxic alkaloids, blocks the sodium channel in nerve axons, causing the loss of sensation and paralysis. The dinoflagellate produce a toxin, saxitoxin neurotoxin. Contaminated shellfish, when it uptakes those dinoflagellate, the shellfish get contaminated. When the human consume, the human get dizziness, numbness, the mouth, the muscle weakness, nausea will happen automatically. So this is the pathway of the sodium channel. The sodium will get entered into the channel through the impulse propagates. The calcium uptake and the sodium intake will happen. But when the saxitoxin affects the neural toxin affect the sodium channel, what will happen? The toxin blocks the channels. Uptake of sodium and intake of calcium is both get affected, and hence there will be the loss of sensation and paralysis happens. And this is the inhibition mechanism. Aflatoxin from food and inhibition by hepatitis B causes the primary liver cancer. In China, more than 50 picogram per ml microcystin multiplies the risk of colorectal cancer by inhibiting the serine 309 phosphatase. This is a protein phosphatase inhibitor, results in hyperphosphorylation of proteins after cytoskeleton structure. So the MCLR, which is the microcystis leucine and arginine, induce the oxidation of nitrogen's base, leads to the oxidative stress, which induces hepatotoxicity and causes the genotoxicity. And in turn, does DNA get damaged with the cultured cells you derive from the human hepatoma, which is HepG2 cell line, induce the formation of oxidative purines, accumulation of lesions happens. So this damage the cell line derived from the human colon adenocarcinoma, CACO2, human astrocytoma, IPDDCA2, human B lymphoblastoid, NCNC. These all causes the damage to the DNA with a concentration of the 5 microgram per ml. So this is the minute concentration of this toxin results in this much trouble to the human mechanism. And the Cylindrosporum of Borsky is a cyanobacteria. Cyanotoxins, which encodes the genes polyketide synthetase, PKS, and peptide synthase enzymes. These are all the enzymes majorly causes the toxicity. This inhibits the protein synthesis in the liver, causes the DNA damage. This DNA damage happened in Palm Island, Australia. 148 people hospitalized with hepatitis syndrome. And Afanisomum and Ovalisporum produce the sign gene, which is a Cylindrosporomopsin gene, produce these, which are involved in the aminotransferase, hybrid non-ribosomal peptide synthase, polyketide synthase, and polyketide synthase. These enzymes are literally involved in the genetic relationship of the sign gene production causes the toxin. And here comes the objectives. We have worked in the Viranam Lake of Kadalur district. So we just wanted to analyze this. Viranam Lake is called the Viranarayanan Lake from the period of Chola King, who built the Viranam Lake. This nowadays in Chennai, the metropolitan cities like Chennai. When the water scarcity comes, we get the water from Viranam Lake, Kadalur, and we just wanted to study the lake. And nowadays, this is also getting polluted by the human interruptions and many industrial developments. So we just wanted to study the physicochemical parameters of the water. And if there is any trouble with the physicochemical, we will proceed with the cyanobacterial toxins, which is not at all visible through the naked eyes. So before it gets bloomed completely, spoiled the drinking surface drinking water, I wanted to just analyze it. genetic identifications are carried out using the molecular biological method. This materials and methods concerns. Viran and Lake, we have isolated the samples from 6 different locations and using 5 liter can and sterilized screw cap tube. Study of physicochemical parameters of lake water is mandatory to know whether the biological oxidation exists or whether the chemicals are involved in the process of cyanobacterial production. So just wanted to know about that. We carried out the physicochemical parameters of lake water and lately the algal identification was also carried out. And this is our group that we went there and collected the lake water and analyzed using the parameters, TDS and conductivity, temperature and all that we have analyzed in 4 different seasons from August 2018 to March 2019. Monsoon, winter and summer seasons has been carried out. So excessive growth of the toxic species are the indicator of the water pollution. To understand the factors affecting the massive growth, we need to monitor the characteristics of water, the biological and the physical, chemical and biological properties, which includes the light, temperature, pH, dissolved oxygen, ion concentration, and salinity of surrounding environment. The chemical analysis those includes the pH, TDS, and TSS. Heavy metal analysis like copper, zinc, magnesium, iron, cadmium, lead, chromium, and etc. The water samples were analyzed for pH, temperature, conductivity, turbidity, total dissolved silica, potassium, orthophosphate, COD, chemical oxygen, demand, chromium, zinc, or these are all the parameters, 24 different parameters we have analyzed and compared with the Indian standard values. And this is the can that we used for the collection. And from the screw cap, we have collected the algae bloom as well. And we have cultured it in 25 degree, 12:12 ratio period, light and dark method in a cool white fluorescent lamp. Morphological characteristic of the cyanobacterial stains, LICA, GMIL phase, contrast inverted microscope. We have analyzed the different cyanobacterial existence. And these are all the contaminated cyanotoxins we have identified, which is many species where we have identified, Nabina, nodularians, these many cyanobacteria we have identified. And so these are all the examples of the water get polluted every day by day. Some green algae was also identified. So using this, from that, we have serially diluted all the samples in 6 different sites. We have serially diluted. And then with the BG11 media, we collected the samples. And then single colonies have been identified like this. The microcystis. This is a microcystis species isolated from the four to five species of each site. And this is another oscillatory species I have identified. The species selection and mode of the toxicity levels, and still the research is in the progress. So the toxin are produced by the sources of nodularia, nostac, anabina, afanizomenin. Produce the toxins, that is secondary metabolites, are nodularic, microcystin, anatoxin, AAS, zaxitoxin. So these are all the molecular structures, the cyclic pentapeptide, heptapeptide, guanidine, methyl phosphate esters, alkaloid. The, what are the mode of toxicity is, it modularin affects the hepatotoxic tumor promoters, which inhibiting the protein phosphatase enzyme. The microcystin inhibit the protein phosphatase enzyme and also causes the hepatotoxicity. Anatoxin is a neurotoxin. Choline esterase inhibits the choline esterase, and zaxitoxin is an alkaloid from the afanizomenin, inhibits the sodium channel, causes a neurotoxin. So the analytical techniques for toxin identification carried out after that. Analytical techniques such as reverse phase LC-MS, which is liquid chromatography mass spectrometer, the cyanotoxins in the water bodies. After toxin identification, the appropriate bioassay can be chosen based on the biological activity of toxin as well as the facilities which are available. These are all the some general physicochemical methods for the detection of toxicity. So the micro after the toxin have been after the cyanobacteria has been isolated from the water and cultured in it in a tissue culture lab. Once the single colonies have been identified, we will go for the genetic level identification. And this is after the DNA isolation PCR is being carried out, we can go for the toxin identification by using the LC-MS. LC-MS. Mass confirmation can be carried out using PDM. MALDI-TOF is another technique used for toxin identification. It is the recently developed one which is more accurate to identification. NMR is also used, which is a little bit high cost when compared to another MALDI-TOF and LC-MS. But it can, but it does need the expert interpretation. We need milligram quantity, whereas some others we needed only microgram quantity to check the toxin level. Anatoxin A or AS can also be analyzed using the LC-MS. Zaxitoxin, these are all the sensitive and very specific methods and suitable for all kind of variants. And the bioassay can be carried out for identification. These bioassays are mandatory to keep the toxin level below the safe level guidelines, which are proposed by WHO. Though every method has its own limitation, we have to combine all the bioassays which can be adopted in cases where more than one type of toxin is suspected, because while some species will be emitting some kind of toxin which are not able to analyze some with the use of one particular bioassay. Some toxins can be used with another kind of bioassay. So in combination with the different bioassays, this toxicity can be easily studied. Some techniques may not be sufficient to identify all the variants. So the combinatorial studies are much advisable. So these are all the bioassay tests. The mammalian cell line can be carried out, enzyme bioassay can be carried out, fish bioassay and mouse bioassay can be carried out to identify the toxin. And here I have given the cost-wise thing also. The mammalian cell lines like hepatocytes and neuroblastoma cell lines can be collected from the institution. And this is very rapid test. Mammalian cell line is rapid test, and, but the careful standardization method need to be carried out. The enzyme bioassays like acetylcholinesterase, ELISA enzyme linked immunosorbent assay method, and protein phosphatase inhibitor enzymes can be carried out to check the anatoxin toxin, saxitoxin, and the microcystis and nodular toxin. So this is the only alternative bioassay for AAS. AAS in the sense, anatoxin AAS for this kind of a toxin. Only this bioassay is preferable. And the ELISA is not. ELISA technique, though it produces a perfect identification for the COVID kind of a toxin, but this is not suitable for all kind of variants. So protein phosphatase inhibitors is medium cost and it is very sensitive as well. The fish bioassays like Molly fish and also Danny Orido and zebra mussels can also be carried out from the sites. We can isolate those fishes from the site and we can inject it directly into it and check the toxin level. So these can be used for microcystin, nodularin, anatoxin and zaxitoxin, etc. And this is very sensitive method. Mouse bioassays like albino mouse can be carried out for these toxins, which are very medium and very sensitive as well. Gene identification using molecular biological method, the morphological discrimination between toxic and non-toxic cyanobacteria, it'll be very difficult. So the DNA-based detection methods can be carried out, and it is very potential specificity for targeting the genes. Those are involved in the toxin biosynthesis, which is very sensitivity and it improves the speed as well. Quantitative, qualitative information on regulation at the gene, mRNA, and protein levels, as well as toxin quantification, gives the complete picture of toxin production in response to various environmental conditions and as well as the ecological situations. The quantitative analysis of the toxins are carried out for the quantitative analysis for toxin identification using 16S rRNA gene is the most widely used for the identification, especially for the cyanobacteria gene identification. And the DNA fingerprinting method can be carried out for analyzing the sequences of the amplified genes and quantify the number of genes in the samples. BLAST is a tool used for the, which is a database use similar sequences and predict the phylogeny of the particular species. qPCR method is another method which is used to quantify the toxin genes is associated with the production of the microcystis, anatoxin, acylloscomoxin, and the saxitoxins, etc. This is the DNA-based approach for the detection. Then we have to collect the sample, as I told you earlier, collect the sample from the lake, and the DNA, we have to isolate the DNA, and the PCR has been carried out. After that, once the PCR done, the qPCR can be carried out, followed by the RFLP and the sequencing. Lately, the BLAST technique interpretations can be carried out. From the RFLP, we can check the qualitative evaluation, and qPCR, we can check the quantitative of the toxin genes. Here comes the conclusion. Environmental factors that affects the toxin productions, which are key importance for understanding the ecology of toxin cyanobacteria, as well as predicting toxin events. The bioassays, quantitative and qualitative analysis is mandatory in order to detect the toxicity or levels for the health reasons. To that end, it is essential to monitor toxin gene expression and the abundance of toxic biosynthesis proteins in response to a wide range of physical, chemical, biotic factors. After analyzing the pH, after analyzing the parameters, we have concluded the pH is slightly alkaline, which is not suitable, which is declining from the drinking water susceptibility, and the turbidity, orthophosphates, total dissolved oxygen, TDS, biological oxygen demand, chemical oxygen demand, iron, lead, were not in the accepted limit by this Indian standard value. Hence, the water is slightly polluted and definitely need to monitor and properly maintain to maintain the human health, and many kids, many pregnant women, and everyone is taking the water from this lake. And so this need to be monitored regularly, and the cyanobacterial pollution we need to stop in order to stop the hepatotoxin and liver toxins for humans and fishes and birds, etc. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice presentation. What a remarkable that you are working there on cyanotoxins.
Thank you.
So, any question from the participant? So, ma'am will give the answer, and if any doubt, so you can ask directly to the ma'am. There is no question, but one feedback is there, ma'am, in the chat box. Very nice lecture, ma'am, from the student Maria Khan.
One question.
Thank you so much to all of them, and for the sir.
One question is there, ma'am.
Who has given me the opportunity and wonderful time for me.
I'm Dr. Shravan Didi from Geography Department in this college. I am having a question that the pollution which is being going on. So, what effects are seen due to this pollution, and what effect to this algae, that I want to know.
There are actually. Sorry, go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. You can continue, ma'am.
Actually this is a major pollutions like the coronavirus, and it is going to become like a bio war as well. Before that, we need to monitor the every lakes which are getting affected, and every urbanizations, because of the nowadays people are washing with the soaps. Earlier they were taking bath in the lake, and they were not using soaps and detergents, etc. But nowadays people are using the old method and introducing their own detergents by washing the dresses and washing the things and everything. So because of that, what happens, the availability of the nutrients, it gives more nutrients to the lake water, where the carbon and nitrogen, the everything is being produced. So literally what happens, all the algae will consume all the things. Lately, this becomes bloom and causes the demand, the biological oxygen demand is being caused. Because of that demand, what happens to the fishes, the surface water fishes, the natural water fishes will consume all that, will not get the oxygen. So it will eventually die, or because of the toxin level, toxicity, and the pollution level also, people are not going for the proper treatment of water. Secondary treatment or tertiary treatment were not carried out. But the cyanobacteria is a microbiological, very, very microscopically organism. So even in the tertiary treatment, if you don't do it properly, what happens? The cells will get damaged. The outer cell membrane get damaged. Because of that, the inner cell line contains the toxin, which release the toxin outside the cell membrane. That toxin will just emerges out, and by consuming that toxin by the fishes, or after the fishes, the birds will get consumed, or the fishes being consumed by the nearby place area people also, they get affected, or the stomach get upset, or the neural problem will causes like the nausea or vomiting or headache. That causes every day, they does not even know because of this is happening. They don't even know because of that. Many toxic producing algae is also there, but for the treatment process also, they does not know that these organisms will secrete the toxin through the treatment, from the treatment method also. And many people the gym, we're going for the sports people, what they are producing the protein from algae, single SCP proteins, no, from the algae. So they are taking the protein content from the drink. So they don't even know they are also drinking the cyanobacteria along with the spirulina product. Spirulina is a single cell protein they are consuming for the sportsmen and all that. So also they are giving more protein is needed for the pregnant women as well. So once it is not properly cultivated, the spirulina is not properly cultivated, or they are not checking the water level properly, then it will definitely affect the liver of human and liver of fishes and even the plants inside the lake water. So this is the major cause. Thank you.
Parvin Bano, you have one question that you are raising your hand. So unmute yourself and ask your question. She is raising her hand, but she won't able to ask the question. You can type your question in the chat box. No, ma'am, no any response from her. So,
okay, sir.
No. Okay, so thank you very much, ma'am, for your nice presentation according to the cyanotoxins and what effect they are on the globally. So we are very much thankful that you are been here on our invitation. So we are thankful to you, ma'am. Very much.
I'm honored with your invitation as well, sir. Thank you so much. I'll be looking for the more invitations from you, and wanted to proceed as many as research work through webinars. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
One request to you, ma'am. I was working on plant drugs. So if any of the difficulty, okay, that I will contact you for the some because you told that you are specializing in bioinformatics also, na? So
yes, sir. Sure, sir. You are welcome. Yes. Anytime we are here to help you, help everyone. and whatever that I know, I can definitely do from my part.
That's our pleasure, ma'am. That's our pleasure. That we are very much thankful to you. So now I call upon the HOD of Geography Department, Dr. Sawant sir, to present a vote of thanks.
Thanks.
For vote of thanks, I am Dr. Sawant Didi from Geography Department. Thank you, ma'am. You are being with us for this webinar.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
It has been organized by our JIT Arts, Science and Commerce College, Malegaon, District Nasik, Maharashtra. Always our chairman, our principal, our organizing committee, who are giving us a time, and always they are cooperating to us. So we have arranged this program, webinar, as an online program. So in a one invitation, you had given us information here, confirmation. So we are thankful to you, ma'am. And all the participants who have participated for this webinar, I also thank to them from our management, from principal, and all our organizing committee. So thank you, ma'am. Again, whenever we are in need, whenever we are inviting you, you will be with us. So we are again welcome to you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
One more request to you, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Actually, due to pandemic, our students are not coming to college. We are taking online lectures, sir. So I'm thinking that I will also put your lecture for my student, for especially botany students. So
sure, sir. Sure.
So I will contact you, and we will we will talk about our plan.
I'm pleased.
And, so thank you very much, ma'am.
Sure, sir. I'm very happy to involve. Thank you so much, sir. I'm very happy to do and accepting your invitation. Very lucky to do that as well.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So it is a request to all the participants. Feedback link is being shared by Dr. Sawant sir within a few minutes in the chat box. So kindly fill the feedback.